Okay, one of my favorite pieces of Tupperware. Are we getting a close-up of this
yes,
over
all,
here?
Yes, oh, John's been doing
wonderful.
A lot of good camera work.
Okay, good. Thank you, John. Now, this is an average can of your corned beef hash, right? This is the Tupperware can opener. Now, you know those typical can openers, the traditional can openers, right?
We probably own one.
The ones that have that little, little rubber handles.
They get rusty and dirty.
They get rusty. And what do rusty can openers carry? Bacteria.
Ugh.
And you can't wash bacteria out of rust. So once you have a rusty can opener, you really should throw it away. But most of us keep that piece of crap. And what we do is, Tim's going to open up a can of beefarini. He pulls his can opener out. He puts it on the side of the can. And we start turning. And what usually happens, it starts to slip, right?
Yeah. And then bacteria's getting in there. And the container he's going to put that in, the old Chinese food container.
It's horrible.
Break down some more.
Yeah, and then finally he gets the damn thing open after scissoring the can open, and you're digging it out with a fork, a knife, a spoon. Don't be doing that, okay? It's disgusting. Every can that comes off the conveyor belt at a factory has a seal that holds this lid to the base of the can. So there's no reason to cut the metal open if we can pop the seal. Now, I'm going to show you
how it works.
Yes, totally. Listen to this. Okay. Now, I'm going to show you, because what's going to happen is you're going to get this home. You're going to throw away the instruction and go, oh, I know how to open a can. Then you're going to be sitting there going, how does it work? I don't know. I didn't pay attention. Blah, blah, blah. Here's how you do it. Nice and easy. When you get it, the first thing you do is grab it. You'll notice it has two legs. One is black. One is white. Spread them. Hold the black leg. It's slightly thicker and noticeably longer.
The black one.
Yes. Approach your can from the top, not the side. You're going to approach it from the top. You're going to approach it. You're going to mount it and squeeze the legs together. Do you see how I successfully mounted that can? Now, you're going to hold the legs tightly together, grab the big knob and screw. And just keep screwing until it feels loose and easy. Now, you'll feel something pop, so you spread it and lift. Now, does it look like that can of corned beef hash is open? No. Well, watch this. Tupperware gives you a little pair of pliers, a little grabber right here. With one hand, you just hold the can. With the other hand, you snip the top off. And look how we, and look, no, ow, no sharp edges. Just kidding. Oh, I can smell that delicious corned beef hash.
It does have an aroma.
But let me show you this. Now, let's pretend this was dog food, and you wanted to give your dog some of the food. You could, right, because he's throwing up on the couch. You'll eat the rest later. You put this back on top, and look, you could serve that later. Now, does it look like that can has been opened?
No.
It doesn't. I could suck the corned beef hash out of here, fill it with dirt, glue the top back on, and bring it back to Stop and Shop. Or
fill it with dirt and glue.
You'll save thousands of dollars in canned goods. But if I wanted to be a nasty bitch, I would carry this in my handbag, go over to your house for a cup of coffee. You go to use the toilet. I'll open every can in your cupboard. Put it back, and in 2 weeks, your whole family has diarrhea. All thanks to item number 1291, our Tupperware can opener.
I love the can opener.
I've never seen a can opener like that.